Where are we today?
You're in Port Hope's Opera House, originally called the Music Hall.
Who was it owned by? Because I think there was somebody.
It was owned by and built by the O'Neill brothers, who were merchants on Walton Street. So it was built in 1879. A couple of Irish businessmen who have made their business based really upon the fact that Port Hope is a really active harbor.
When they opened up the Music Hall, what kind of things were shown here?
Their opening concert had a mixture of things. It had a military band, and it had a soprano, it had people who did recitations.
What was the heyday for this music hall?
That's hard to say because the downstairs has been built as a business, so commercial stores. It's hard to make money on individual concerts and keep it going. And it mixed whether it was concerts or whether it was drama, imported or local. And Canada depended upon local amateur dramatics really until the creation of the Stratford Festival in 1953. It was at first built with hanging chandeliers. The roof burned out in the mid-1890s. They rebuilt it and built this stage that we're standing on. And a bathroom there that we wouldn't want to describe as a bathroom. And a fire hose in the corner that we wouldn't want to rely on. Because the building had a big problem, and that was fire safety. But then the building morphed into being used for silent movies. And behind you, at the very end of the hall, is the tin covering behind which there would be asbestos, because of course projectors are very dangerous. And the balcony actually projected out further than what we can see today. That got reduced because after the Capitol Theater opened and became our theater and movie place for the town, this became a badminton club.
A badminton club.
And then we have on the far wall posters.
Yes.
Some of them not exactly ones we would want to put up on the wall today.
Can you point out any architectural pieces within the room that are sort of significant or something that is like you don't see anywhere else?
Well, it's the windows. These are 16-foot Palladian-style windows with large pane glass, which let in a wonderful amount of light. It feels strange, though, to have it behind the stage. You think the stage should be at the far end of the building. That's really what makes the building, gives it this classical Palladian assembly hall type of feel.
Right.